Hi guys, this is the Jabra Elite 65T, which was released by this Denmark audio manufacturer in early 2018. I've been using this since 2019 and it's still working perfectly. And now I'm going to tear this down to show you what's inside. The cover is only held by this snap fit, so there is no magnet to keep it closed. You can see the plastic flexes a little if I squeeze it. This provides the compliance needed for the snap to slide out. If this was too stiff, this tiny piece of plastic would probably break in half before you can even open the cover. This is a KC marking, which says that this product complies to the Korean safety standards. And this is a Japanese equivalent of the FCC marking, which tells us that the Bluetooth transmission is approved by the Japanese authority. There are a bunch of numbers and a QR code, which I guess is related to production. And the CE marking can be found on the other side. And if you Google these numbers, you will be able to find the Declaration of Conformity document, which lists out all the standards that this product is conformed to. The top rubber can be taken out relatively easily. It is only held down by a few undercuts. There is a magnet here, which is used for the cover detection. We will come back to this magnet very shortly. Here we can see the undercuts and the alignment features that hold the rubber in the right place. The bottom rubber can be taken out also quite easily. And I think this is where it gets interesting. There are quite a few things happening within this piece of rubber. First of all, there is a tiny transparent plastic that guides the LED light from the PCB to the top of the rubber. And there is also a magnetic rod right next to the light guide. The rod does not create a magnetic field around it, as we can also see its behavior on this magnet viewing film. What it does is to carry the magnetic field from the magnet that we saw earlier to the cover detection sensor on the PCB, which is located in the bottom half of the charging case. This is quite different from the Apple AirPods charger, which uses a flexible circuit for the cover detection. There are two magnets here which I think tell each of the earbuds that they are inside the charging case. These two magnets have the same size as the one that we saw earlier. And this makes it easier to assemble without any confusion. And look at these two cutouts. They line up perfectly with the ribs on the charging case. I think the engineer wanted to add supports under the rubber where the earbuds are placed. And I'm guessing the cut was made on the rubber to provide extra constraint in this direction. I really like looking at a part like this because there are so much to see and learn from. And trying to understand the reason behind each feature is like solving a fun puzzle. Let's move on to the rest. These two pins act as the hinge of the cover. And let me try to take them off now. I spent the next 15 minutes trying to remove the pins without damaging the plastic. I first used a sharp knife to lift the pin up from the slot. Then I used a wire cutter to pinch the pin out. After taking one pin off, I could force the cover out and remove the other pin. I would then remove the battery connector before I remove the three screws holding down the PCB. And there is a piece of foamy tape on the underside of the PCB to hold the battery in place. Pogo pins are used for the connection to the earbuds. And the charging port is connected to the PCB via these springy contact pins. The battery is stuck to the case with double-sided tape. The charging port and the battery level LED are installed underneath the battery, being held down by a plastic clamp. The small PCB can be separated from the clamp. Part of the clamp is transparent and it guides the LED light to the outside of the case. It looks like it is made by a two-part injection molding process, because I cannot separate the two parts. And that is everything inside the Jabra Elite 65T. It has 20 components and is very easy to disassemble. Let's put it back together to see if it still works. Let me know down in the comments what you think about the teardown, and I'll see you in the next video.